On March 29, 2018, the website and media outlet Skift put out an article titled, "Boeing's newest Dreamliner is more of a regional aircraft than its predecessors." The article asserts that its range, which is lower than its 787-8 and -9 siblings, will limit it to more regional flying. But nearly 7 years later, has this been the case? Is Boeing's 787-10 more of a regional aircraft? In this video, we take a look at the 787-10's characteristics as well as how airlines are specifically using this higher capacity Dreamliner, examining some of the longest routes that the jet is being deployed on. So, let's get started. First, it's worth looking at the technical specifications and performance characteristics of the jet as compared to other members of the 787 family. Size is the main differentiating factor between the jets, as the -8 is the shortest and the -10 is the longest. The -9 obviously sits in the middle. The -8 has an FAA exit limit of 381 passengers, the -9's exit limit is 420 seats, and the -10's limit is 440 seats. And so, when it comes to MTOW, -8 being about 227.9 metric tons, and the -9 about 254.7 metric tons. Interestingly, the -10's MTOW is a little over 254 metric tons. That's right, it's slightly less than the -9. By the way, all of this data comes from Boeing's document titled 787 Airplane Characteristics for Airport Planning. And so, when it comes to fuel, the 787-8 carries about 33,340 US gallons of usable fuel, about 126,200 liters. The -9 appears to carry just 60 more gallons than the -8, with a capacity of about 33,400 or 126,430 liters. Finally, for the -10, it's the exact same as the -9, so the numbers don't need repeating. And so, when we look at the fact that the -10 is the largest 787, but carries the same amount of fuel as the -9, it's no wonder that its range is decreased. Per Boeing's website, the 787-8 has a range of about 7,300 nautical miles, or 13,530 kilometers, while its 7,565 nautical miles, or 14,010 kilometers, for the -9. And the 787-10's range is the lowest of the trio, coming in at 6,330 nautical miles, or 11,730 kilometers. And of course, we always have to note that these marketing figures are less often the case in the real world. Nonetheless, they give us a rough guide as to how the jets compare with one another. So, yes, the Skift article is correct in highlighting that the -10 won't be deployed on the same game-changing ultra-long-haul routes as its smaller siblings. As Qantas's current go-to aircraft for its longest non-stop flights, its -9s are deployed on those long 17-plus-hour services between Perth and London or Paris. Air Canada's 787-9s, when heading back to Vancouver from Dubai, have flight durations nearing 16 hours. Nope, the 787-10 wouldn't be capable of making such a journey with a cabin full of passengers and cargo. But is it more of a regional aircraft? Its longest non-stop routes for December would say otherwise. The fifth longest 787-10 service scheduled is operated by KLM between Amsterdam and Los Angeles. This has a great circle distance of nearly 9,000 kilometers, or 4,850 nautical miles. The 787-10 is actually used quite often by KLM to serve American cities, with the type also being deployed transatlantic to Chicago, New York, and Atlanta. The fourth longest non-stop 787-10 flight is also operated by KLM, its service between Amsterdam and Taipei. This route has a great circle distance of about 9,460 kilometers, or 5,100 nautical miles. For this particular route, it's worth noting that airspace restrictions for Ukraine and Russia have resulted in a less direct flight path, making for a longer flight. And so, according to recent Flight Radar 24 history, the flight back to Amsterdam from Taipei can be as long as 14 hours. Third on the list is yet another KLM service, with flights between Amsterdam and Rio de Janeiro. The Great Circle distance covered is 9,535 kilometers, or about 5,150 nautical miles. Despite being the longer route by Great Circle distance, it does not have the same airspace restrictions as going from Amsterdam to Taipei. Thus, the flight towards Rio is often about 11 hours, quite a bit less than the previous route. Finally, breaking away from KLM flights, we have EVA Air's service between Taipei and Seattle. This route has a Great Circle distance of 9,775 kilometers, or about 5,280 nautical miles. With airspace restrictions not having any huge impact for this service, the longer flight heading west towards Taipei currently has an average duration of about 12.5 hours. And finally, the Boeing 787-10's longest scheduled non-stop flight for the month of December 2024 is United Airlines service between Chicago O'Hare and Tokyo Haneda. This has a distance of about 10,150 kilometers or 5,480 nautical miles. In terms of flight duration, the longer service heading west towards Tokyo can be as long as 13 hours. So, as you can see, the 787-10 is being used by airlines to operate some fairly long intercontinental services, pushing the aircraft closer to its range limit. Route number 4 is particularly impressive given its tendency to have 13 to 14 hour flight durations. What we don't know is how airlines are loading their 787-10s for such long services. Yes, we know that all of these airlines are network carriers with a good amount of premium seating resulting in fewer passengers on board. But we don't know if or how much airlines are limiting cargo weight to ensure sufficient reserve fuel for the long journey. Yes, it is true that some airlines want to have a little more fuel capacity to allow the same aircraft to reach just a few more cities beyond the jet's reach, or at least operate those same routes year-round, regardless of seasonal wind variations. It's why some airline customers have been pestering Boeing for a higher gross weight variant of the 787-10. As reported by The Air Current in 2023, Boeing has been looking at IGW variants of the Dash 8 and Dash 9, with IGW standing for increased gross weight. For the Dash 10, this would allow the jet to fly with an additional 6.4 metric tons of payload, resulting in an additional 430 nautical miles of range. Nonetheless, the Boeing 787-10 in its current form seems perfectly fine to fly transatlantic and transpacific, and so calling this jet, quote, more of a regional aircraft than the Dash 8 and Dash 9 would be a bit of an exaggeration. But what do you think? Is range really an issue for the 787-10? Let us know your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.